Hello everybody, and welcome to the Whisper Games. And today I'm doing my Halloween special of 2015. I decided to play some Don't Starve today. It's not really a scary game, but it's got a sort of atmosphere to it that I kind of think is fitting for Halloween. So I think I might play as Wendy or Woody. I think I'm going to go for Wendy today. So I'm just going to play for a little bit. I'm aiming at somewhere around 1.5 hours, maybe 2. Just going to play like casually and soft speak, or speak softly to you. And I probably will start whispering instead after a while, because whispering is kind of easier to do than soft speaking. So if you're not familiar with Don't Starve, it is a game by Klei or Klei Entertainment. And it was released on Steam in April 2013. I think it's out on different consoles now as well. And I would say that it is a survival game. Wikipedia says it's an action-adventure game. So, basically, it's about not starving. It's all in the title, really. There are different ways you can die, though, not just by starving. You can freeze to death in winter or burn. Or you can get killed by different things, like animals and monsters of different kinds. So, the first thing I'm doing is collecting things. I'm trying to find some food and some flint and sticks like this to make tools like the axe that I'm holding right now. And I collected 12 flowers so I can make a garland. And the garland is good for my mental health. There are 3 sort of things that you need to keep an eye on, and you can see them up in the right upper corner. There are 3 symbols under the clock. There's a heart with red background. There's a brain with orange background. And there's a stomach. basically the heart shows your health, the brain shows your mental health, and the stomach shows your hunger. So, oh, I found the eye bone. That's really good. Here comes Chester. So this is, if you pick the eye bone up, this little thingy called Chester, which is, he's like a chest that follows you around. As like a little companion, as long as you keep the eye bone on you, he's really a nice thing. I think I really like Chester. It's nice to have some company, and also it's a good thing to have some extra storage space. But anyway, yeah, the heart is the health. So if you get hurt somehow, that will go down, the meter will go down, and you can see right now my mental health is going down. It's got an arrow that's pointing down, and that means that I'm going insane, basically. Oh, here's a pig house. That's a good thing. This is a good spot for potential base, I think. I think the mental health is going down right now because of the darkness. So I'm gonna make a temporary fireplace. You can also make like a fire pit thing that will stay. You don't have to make a new one every night. You just light some more fire in it, like some logs or something. This one will disappear when it's burnt out. So I made a pickaxe and I'm collecting some rocks. I should say as well that the clock in the upper right corner that says day one on it shows what time of day it is. So it just turned blue now, and that means it's nighttime. And the yellow bit is the daytime, and the red bit is like evening, sort of. And right now the daytime is half of the time of the day, but when we get closer to winter, because it's not winter now, but it will be winter in 20 days, the daytime will get shorter. And when we've had 20 days of winter, it'll go back to summertime, and then the days will be longer again. So I'm trying to see what I want to make. This is the map, so I can see where I've been. You can't see anything else but where you have been previously. So really, all you can do at night is just waiting for the night to end, really. And if you're in the dark, like completely, if you don't have a fire, you will basically die. It's really bad to be in the dark. Okay, so I'm just gonna run around and explore and pick things up again today. You can see it says day two now. I have been playing Don't Starve for, I think, about 2 years or so. Oh, this is good. This is a touchstone. I've activated it, and that means that if I die, or I should say when I die, I will respawn here. So basically, it's like an extra life to find. If you find a touchstone, that means you will be given another shot at surviving, basically. Pick up some flint and a carrot. Yes, I've been playing it for 2 years or so. I tend to have like periods when I'm playing it more, and then periods when I'm not playing it basically at all. I'm gonna try to attack this rabbit. I actually did hit it then, but I think that Wendy is kind of like weaker than some other characters, so I think that's why I didn't like one-shot it. I've made these traps, and basically they are for catching the rabbits. And the rabbits obviously is a way to get food. You will always need food in this game. You can see that my hunger meter has gone down, so it's almost half full or half empty. So that means that I'm going to have to eat soon. Okay, got some more rabbit and some more carrots. I can see there are some flowers there, but I don't really need to pick them right now. I'm just making a like mental note that there are flowers in this area, because I might want to come back later and pick them. If my mental health goes down, it's a good thing to go and pick some flowers, because that will make your sanity go up. Which I think is kind of a neat, kind of cute game mechanic, like, or game rule. Like. Okay, so as you can see, it's turned into nighttime. Well, not nighttime, evening. And it's still okay to run around, but it's darker than when it's daytime. I haven't really gone that far today. I'm sort of just exploring the area that was pretty close to where we did camp out last night. There is an expansion pack for Don't Starve. I don't have it myself, but I know that there is. Oh look, we got some rabbits in our traps. So we're gonna set the trap back and kill the rabbit and go do the same thing over here. I think there's only one expansion so far. It's called Reign of Giants, I think. I have sort of played it a little bit, because there is also a multiplayer Don't Starve Now. And I've played that a bit with a friend of mine, and the Reign of Giants pack, I guess, is in the multiplayer version. So I have played it a bit. It's terrifying. At least the one that we run into. Okay, so I'm back by the pig house, and I think I'm going to make my base here. So I'm gonna make the bigger, like, permanent fire pit here. Gonna chop down these trees. So the next thing I will want to build in my base is a science machine, and for that I will need a piece of gold. So I need to find some gold. I guess we're going looking for that. Ooh, I just about made it back then. Gonna cook the meat from the rabbits. I'm gonna have a little dinner time and fill up that belly of mine. I have decorated a little bit in my flat for Halloween. I don't really celebrate a lot, but I think it's fun to, like, decorate a little bit and dress up, maybe, but I don't really go anywhere. I like Halloween, though. You can sort of get a little bit crazy with decorations and, like, food and stuff, and I like that. And, like, you can dress up and wear silly makeup and things, and I think that's funny. I like to... Oh, there's Mr. Pig, the pig that lives in the house. And it's good to have pigs around, because if there are monsters attacking and the pigs are out, they will, like, automatically attack them. So having pigs around is kind of helpful if you get attacked by monsters. Here's someone has died here. I'm taking his twigs. So I don't know if you have seen, but every character in Don't Starve has, like, a special item. And Wendy has this flower that is somehow connected to her sister, who is dead, and I don't quite remember now how you, like, what you do with it. I know that I have been able to do something with it previously, but I have forgotten what you do with it. I should probably have looked that up. Okay, so here's a graveyard, and if I had a shovel, I would start digging up the graves, which is horrible, but oh, there's some gold, good. You can find some good stuff in the graves. Sometimes you find ghosts as well, which is not as good, but yeah, in graveyards, it's quite common that you will find pieces of gold just lying around. And I found a stone here as well, which has gold in it. There are like two different kinds of big boulders that you can use your pickaxe on, like mine. And there's one kind that has gold in them and one kind that doesn't. There's a road you can see here. Like, this is the gold boulder. You can kind of see the gold ore. There are lots here. It's good to find a place like this, because you will need like lots of stones and things, and gold, possibly, depending on what you want to do. So there is like a story mode to Don't Starve. This is like sandbox mode. And I have actually never even, well, I have tried to play story mode like once. But I usually just play sandbox mode, which is what I'm going to do today. And basically you just try to survive for as long as you can until you die, really. That's the whole point of sandbox mode. And story mode, or like adventure mode, I don't know what you call it really, has like different levels to it. I think there are 5 levels, I'm not sure, but there are like different ways you can play this game. I hope you see what I mean about the kind of atmosphere about the game, the kind of aesthetics are quite like Tim Burton-y, if you know what I mean. I think actually I saw somewhere that the people who developed this game, I think they took like inspiration from Tim Burton and also from Minecraft, I think. I might be just making things up now. I think I read about that quite recently. Let's see if I can make it back to the camp before it gets dark. I think we should be okay. Yeah, that's there's the mushroom and there's the camp. So let's make a little fire and we can now make our science machine. I'm gonna put the flowers there because the pig will eat them. I'm gonna build my science machine, and basically when you have built the science machine you can make more things, and then you can also make an alchemy engine, and that is basically the upgraded version of a science machine. And you can make even more things when you have an alchemy engine. So I made a shovel, which means I can dig things up, like the mushrooms, for example. Okay, so I'm cooking my food. My hunger hasn't gone down that much. I got a lot of berries. I'm gonna eat a little bit as well. Might as well fill my tummy up. I can build hay wall, but I don't really want to do that. Yeah, let's make some rope, because then I can make a spear, which is good for protection. There will be like dogs or wolves attacking somewhere around day 10 or so. They come in like regularly every couple of days. I think it's different, like every time you play. Sometimes they come on like day 8, sometimes they come on day 12, and then they will come again on like day, somewhere around day 20, and so on. And there will be more dogs or wolves for every time, and they will be harder to beat. I'm sort of trying to start preparing for the first attack. We got some more rabbits in our traps, which is good. I'm gonna put one trap here and the other trap here. It's kind of closer to the camp, so I don't have to run. It's not that much further away where they were before, but still. Okay, let's have a little look up here, see what's up here. Lots of beehives. If you destroy them, you get like honey, which you can use to make, for example, like health kits, basically. Like, I don't remember the word for it, but you can put it on to, like, use them to get to refill your health bar or your health meter. So they're good for health. You can also eat honey, obviously. You're gonna watch out for the angry bees, though. Here are some other kinds of trees. I do like the art, like the aesthetics of this game. It's kind of gloomy and like comic-y, like a comic book, sort of. I like that. Oh, here are some spiders. Spoiders. And that's also a good thing to find, because you do need like spider glands like that, and webs for different things. I've got some silk there. The spider gland is for health as well. It's good for, well, it can heal you, basically. So it's good for your health bar. I see some gold over there as well. Okay, so I've got some more silk. And I took out one of the spider nests, basically. Okay, so we know that there are more spiders up here. Well, this is a warp hole, so if you jump in there, which might seem like a bad idea, like judging by what it looks like, but if you do jump in there, you will get teleported or like warped to somewhere else. I'll show you. Let's see where we end up. Okay, so we're in another... Oh, we're literally by the bees. Okay. So that's like a shortcut, but it will... make your mental health go down. We've got a garland though, so it's okay. What the garland does is that as long as it's daytime, your mental health will go up more if you're wearing a garland. Let's try to get this rabbit. There we go. Some extra morsels. It's always good. Here's some more. Let's murder the rabbit. Where's the other trap? Is it down here? Yeah. I think I have time to chop down this tree to get some wood. Can dig up the last bit there, plant some new trees. So I got some manure. Basically, the pig eats the flower petals and he will then produce manure. Which is good. I can then collect that and make like farms and things. It's good for fertilizing like crops and berry bushes and things like that. So, this is one of the uses for silk. With a fishing rod, I can get fish from ponds. Okay, so for making an alchemy engine, I will need some cut stone and some boards. Shall I make a lightning rod? Yeah, why not? Let's put it over here. Oh, bit dangerous there. Going into the dark. But it's alright. So let's put the manure in the chest and the spider stuff as well. Let's put some more logs on the fire. So I need to find some more wood to make that alchemy engine. You can see like different kinds of farms that you need manure, for example, to make, and in these farms you can grow vegetables using seeds. Okay, so as you can see, I needed some grass as well, so I'm gonna go get some grass. I'm not sure what to do with a flower. Okay, so I'm gonna pick all this grass. We're now on day 5, as you can see. So we're getting closer to the first dog attack. I will know. Like when they're coming, there will be a certain sound. And she will also tell me that they're coming. So I then have a little short time to prepare myself. I kind of want to make more pig houses as well, because you can make pig houses to get some more pigs. I'll probably do that in the future. Got another rabbit up there in the trap. Oh, now I've got two. Just saw the other one getting trapped. That was stale, yeah. So the food will kind of go bad after a while, as it would in real life. You can still eat it, but I don't think it will be as good for you, and the character will also be complaining about it. Let's get the rabbits. Some grass. As you can see, there are birds as well in the game, and you can make bird traps to catch the birds. And they may give you food. It's more likely that they will give you a feather, I have found, but it's a possibility that they will give you a morsel when you kill them, so it's not as trustworthy. It's not a trustworthy way to get food as much as a rabbit trap is. Like, the rabbit trap will give you food every time, but the bird trap is more likely to give you feathers. So I prefer to do rabbit traps, and they're also a lot easier to make, because you need silk to make the bird trap. And then you have to go kill a bunch of spiders. So I'm now digging up some saplings. Basically, what I'm going to do is to bring them back to my camp and plant them close to my camp. And that is something that I usually do. It's just bringing the resources closer to home, sort of. And they will grow back after a while. So I will have a little supply of twigs. So let's make some boards. For that alchemy entrance. Let's see. Okay, I think I have everything. So let's make a prototype. Let's place it here next to the science machine. So now I can do even more things than I could before. Just gonna eat some stale berries. Chop down some trees, because I basically used my wood to make those planks or boards, I think they're called. Planks is Minecraft. Oh, there's a noisy car outside. I hope you can't hear that. It will be nice when I have moved, because that will probably mean that I will have so much less noise and even less white noise, I think, because a lot of the time the radiators in my flat are making a lot of noise, especially in winter and like autumn and spring when it's cold out. And I can't like turn them off because that's automated and regulated by, well, the company I hire my flat from. So I can't do anything about it. And also my fridge is being quite noisy. So I can't record in my kitchen where my radiators are more silent. But then the fridge is even worse. So I often find it hard to have complete silence when I'm making my videos. So after I move, which will be the end of December, basically around Christmas, which is not the best time to be moving, but I don't have a choice. Basically after December, I hope I will have better sound quality, because of living in another place. Okay, so I'm gonna dig these saplings up as well. And bring them back to here instead. Got some more manure and I might be able to make a farm soon, which is good. I can grow some vegetables. It is really, really beautiful here now. It's like really autumny. All the trees are basically all orange and red here now, and some trees have started to lose a lot of their leaves already. Some of them have basically all of them left, but it is really autumny and it's starting to get a bit colder. There are minus degrees some days. The grass is all frosty in the morning and I really like it actually. I'm the kind of person who likes the colder months. I prefer cold weather to warm most of the time. Okay, so I made a farm. I'm gonna plant my seed. Then we just wait. But yeah, it's really autumny and lovely outside here in Sweden. It's really getting me in the mood for Halloween. I think autumn is possibly my favorite month, or not month, like part of the year. Like, maybe not when it's all rainy, because sometimes it is very rainy in autumn in Sweden. I kind of like rain though, but not like on a day when I'm just at home. I find it really calming and like cozy when it's raining. But if I have to go to uni or something else, like go outside and go somewhere, it's not as nice anymore. But I like being able to like put on a bit more clothes and like layer up and wear hats and things. I just really like that. Remember I said you can dig up the graves in the graveyard for some treasures? Let's do that now. See if I will be able to do all of them before I have to go back. I probably have time for that. Sometimes you'll just find junk, really. What would be good to find is cogs. So we can make them we can use them to make an icebox, which is like a fridge. And you can store your food in there and it will not go bad as quickly. Which is really good when you're trying to survive. One thing though is when you're digging up graves, your sanity will drop pretty quickly. Which is why I'm picking flowers there, to kind of try to balance that. I'm going to pick up some more manure and I'm going to go dig up some grass and do basically the same thing that I did with the saplings. I'm going to go and plant them in the camp. Now, when you're doing this with grass and with berry bushes, you will need to fertilize them in order for them to grow. The saplings are okay, you don't have to fertilize them, but with grass and berry bushes, it's a different story. So this is the end of day 6. I think I'm gonna switch to whispering now. Guess speaking softly has really started to get to my throat. So let's be whispering from now on. I have a little bit of a cold actually, so also makes it quite hard to speak softly. It is actually surprisingly hard to do that. You might not think it is, or it would be hard to speak softly or even whisper for a long time, but it can really be. Okay, so let's pick that flower and this one. I'm gonna get some flowers because I can see that my garland is about to disappear. It'll, like, there's like a duration on it. So basically it also goes bad, just like a garland would do in real life. And then you will have to make a new one. So I'll need to find 12 new flowers. Gears yet. Let's try this one. I don't think it's very high, like the chances are not that very high to find cocks, I don't think. Was that all of them? I think it might have been. Oh well. Let's pick up some rocks, because I've used quite a few of them. Let's use my pickaxe to mine this boulder. Get some flint and rocks. And I'm usually leaving the nitre. I don't know how to pronounce it, the nitre. The yellow stuff. Because I haven't really found a way to use it yet. I'm sure there's a use for it, but I have never yet had to use it. So there's no point carrying it around. If I need some reason, I can just go and find it where I left it. Okay, so I think these are the boulders we were at before, or maybe this is a new place. I'm not sure actually. This way. I'll save these berry bushes for later. I know they're here now. Get some more flowers for my garland. See what clothes I can make. I'm looking for this football helmet is good for protection, like armor kind of thing. Which is good for when the dogs come. Should be doing pretty soon. It'll be day 8 after this night. So they can really turn up any minute now. There should be maybe 3 of them the first time. Something that I'm usually doing for like protection from the dog is a little like stone room, and I usually go in there and the purpose of that is basically to there's like an opening where I can go in and where the dogs can come in. Basically the idea is to not have them attack me all at once, but maybe one or two at a time. It works kind of well. Not fantastic, but in my opinion, it works better than just not having any kind of wall at all. Okay, so I'm gonna make some charcoal. Highlighting these trees on fire. And that will give me charcoal. Like so. Okay, which one? Have this one as well, but maybe it doesn't work. Yeah, I'm just a bit Let's make that little stone room.
Logs for fire. That was
was really close. Let's use some grass. Box I was talking about. You need some gears for that though, and we didn't find any. So I can't make that. I kind of want to do a hammer because if I make a hammer, that means I can go in. From the place where the touchstone is. If you remember the touchstone, which is the one that will revive me if I die. The one that had pig heads around it. Basically, I can destroy the pig heads and I will then get pig skin, which I can use for making big houses, for example, or that helmet I was looking at before, the football helmet, which is good armor. But let's make a garland first. It's 11, one more. Having a new garland. This is actually a game that I play like for. I usually play quite casually, which is why I haven't really done the story mode. If I'm just like, I want to play something that doesn't, you know, that you can play without having to think about what you're doing so much. Like, you can just mess around and see where it takes you, sort of. A game you can play to kind of relax a bit, even though this game can be a little bit stressful sometimes with dog attacks and things. It kind of is a game that I play in a sort of relaxed way, if you know what I mean. as the rest of that tree I chopped down in panic last night. Let's make some more charcoal. So we can make the big house. We need boards and cut stone and pig skin for that. As you can see, so the touch stone was over here. It's actually right here. So with the hammer I can break the big heads. using the map where there are berry bushes, which is good if you really need food. You can go and have a look where you have found berry bushes before. I haven't actually been in this area, but there might be some down here. Or maybe not. Ourselves a nice pumpkin. I'm gonna just cook. And where am I gonna plant these then? I don't want to put it too close to the lightning rod, because that means they might catch on fire if they're strike, so I'm gonna put them like that and hope that it's not too close. I'm gonna need to fertilize those though. Okay, so a pumpkin and corn. Got some meatballs. Yummy, yummy meatballs. Some more food. Right. I'm thinking about what to do next. Let's go up here for a bit. birds will go around eating the berries from the bushes, and they're really quick as well, so they basically will steal the berries from you if you're not careful. snack as I'm walking, because why not? Let's check the traps. And set them back. Okay, now we're home. Let's hang up some new a new piece of meat on the drying rack. To pick up the manure. And start a little fire. Seeds and let's use the manure to fertilize a little bit. Okay, let's do some cooking. And now let's see. So that road just loops around, and that's the wormhole we came through. I'm gonna pick some more flowers, some grass. Chop down a tree. Guess I seem to use up a lot of wood all the time. Let's chop this one down as well. Whilst I'm at it, fish is obviously edible, so you can eat the fish. The frog got a bit too close to me. Okay, I'm gonna see if I can find a pond where there are no frogs, like, close to it. Spiders too. That's a bigger nest. Here they come. I might have to think about getting back to the camp. Unless I'm staying out tonight. I could do. What you saw there in, well, to the left was another kind of beehive that you don't really want to get close to because they have really aggressive bees. I don't recommend trying to attack them or anything. You can, of course, if you want to, but so, and well, the problem is that there are usually lots of them in the same place. I'm making my temporary camp there. I'm just gonna run around a little bit, see what I've got close to the camp. Well, close to. Something useful while I wait. changing a little bit in my inventory as well. Makes things easier to find. Oh, hello. This is a flower and it's not really, well, it's not harmful in this stage. You might find beefaloes, which is like buffaloes basically, but they're big and hairy. They look a little bit like mammoths, but they're buffaloes, you know. And they also produce manure, so if you can't find any pigs, you might want to go look for big grass areas where you might find beefaloes. Doesn't seem to be any in this one though. I might have missed them, but soon, because it's been quite a long time now. It's becoming quite long and my voice is starting to go, so it might be a good time to stop soon. I hope that this has been a relaxing video.